Hello, today we will be making cake, Smashables Ninja. So what we do is, I use silicone shapes, that's what round I have. You can use any round shape what you like. It will work with any. And I use for this cake two boxes, two of chocolate cake, because I wanted to make actually something to eat. One is not enough. So when it's nicely done, so it's baked and cooled now, so I just tiny bit level. It's not really important in this particular case, because it's whatever round you want to make it or pile up on top, doesn't really matter. But so what we do is, next we have a look, and we want tiny bit trim it on the sides, because we want to leave just here for feet. So what we do, we just simply trim it just the top. Just to see where is your feet will be, that's all. We just want it on the feet. All other, it doesn't matter, because it's around. We will also boost up with buttercream. So now what we do is, whoops, let's clean up this area. Once we finish cleaning, as you can see, we just done only tiny bit on top and just leave this area actually undone. With this particular cake, it's not really important to be precise, because we will boost up everything with our buttercream, and you can shape it as you really like it. We just want to leave a little bit here for actual feet. So what we do is, we have our buttercream, which is recipe I put in the description box, and we are using black gel food coloring, Wilton brand. I just add bit by bit until we get some sort of resemblance of a gray color, and we start applying our buttercream everywhere, all over. Do not worry to be nice precise, because this kind of cake we will after use a fork to sort of make it look fluffy. As you can see, I apply kind of disorderly all this sort of basically our smashable. It's okay, because a tiny bit of our butter frosting is left, so I added a little tiny drop of the golden creamy peach gel food coloring. You can add pink or tiny bit of red, doesn't really matter. It's more just to make resembles of a feet, basically. You can even add ivory if you like. So what we do in this point, we're not finished up with our top such as yet. We will add our feet. So just like this, because that's not important. We put on top extra of buttercream. So let's go and go down now a little bit. I made it quite stiff this time. Okay, let's go finish up. Once you finish applying your little feet, which is a shape with my knife, if you have enough of gray buttercream, you can actually put right around a cake and just feed. I probably have a look, can I actually spread it around? If I can't, so I just leave it like that. sort of. See, we can use a little bit of extra from outside just to make more realistic sort of way. It does not have to be smooth or precise, because this is a smashable. It's not a smooth kind of see, just tiny bit of gray just to cover this and only leave our feet exposed. Alright, so what we do is, once we're done our feet, then I just apply all rest of our butter cream on top. And what we do is, with tiny bit, just a tiny bit like that, we spread it around, just a tiny. Just everywhere around. Then we can use fork to making resembles of a hairy ball. Just make sure it just look like a really, really hairy. My butter cream is really stiff, but from one hand it's good because it's easier to work, kind of, because when you have it cakes like smashable, it's better to have it harder, but it's sometimes it's difficult in some parts. Well, that looks to me quite nice. That's how it's look like right now. So next step is to put our eyes. We have I purchased two, I think they're called gobbles or something. Yep. And what we do is we place one that's middle here, it's be somewhere around here. We just literally put it in like that, and we put another one next to it. Here we are. Now, next is what I like to do. I use a tiny bit of ready to roll icing. I have leftover from before. So I just take a little bit and roll it. We can make it a ninja sort of thing, a headpiece. So once I roll this ready to roll icing, that's how I get it. Just a small, you don't need a really big piece. It's I smell very good of this icing kind of, and it tastes very good too. So what we do is I just roll it and resemble of a basically head bend for our ninja. Next is we have to apply our eyes, which is we started right on the middle, and we just put black around them. Oops, it's not much must be left. Let's have a look. Just the one. Now next one is we will apply red. Around. Here we are. And from a little bit of buttercream frosting left, so I add ivory gel food coloring to just to resemble our let's have a look how it goes. Yeah, okay. Just to resemble our eyelids, because that's what they look like on our ninja. Here one. We can use same one for mouth as well. Here we go. And we continue with another eye, something. Once we finish applying our eyes, that's how it look like now. So it's we need to put a little round dot, so we can use one of candy melts, red one, just to place it just like that, or we can simply squeeze a little bit of our, let's have a look. Get to this one. I just take another tube. So what we do is for build we using the strawberry build, and it's like a roll up sort of. So what we do is we place it's actually a tiny bit covered with sugar. I just get rid of sugar to make it a little bit more look real sort of. So what we do, we place it one here and this goes right around like that, and the second one goes just around here. And what we do with fill it, we bend it in a position like it actually, let's have a look, and we fold it, place it, and should be a bit on the side, just like that. We need probably tiny bit bend a little bit more. Now what we do is, by the time we're not fighting with this belt, I just go get another tube of red writing and we apply a little round for hand bend. Here we finish now our Smashables Ninja, and I hope you really do like it. And see, for this one, as I said too, we're using strawberry builds. I just get rid of a little bit sugar, because it makes a little bit more red, more attractive. And what basically happened is this little dot is now done. I using red writing icing to put a dot in. You can actually put one of those giant sort of M&M's or red candy melt or something like that if you like it. And I hope you really do like it, our Smashables. So thank you very much for your time with me. Please do write your comments, ideas, subscribe. Love to hear from you. Until next time, goodbye.